Hey guys, Inferno here. Jumping into Microsoft Flight Simulator on the Xbox Series X. So thank you to Microsoft and Xbox for the review key on the Series X. I tried to play this on the PC when it released last year. I think it was about 11 months ago, actually. So when did it come out on PC? Message from Microsoft Flight Simulator team. The last 11 months since our PC release have been nothing but short of amazing due to the wonderful response from the Flight Sim community and from fans all over the world. And now we are about to embark on the next phase of the Microsoft Flight Simulator journey with the coming launch on the Xbox Series X and S. And that's on July 27th. That's when it comes out on the console. I'm pretty lucky. Thank you again, Xbox ANZ, you legends, for letting us have an early look. Now, as I said before, I tried to play it on PC, so I was given a review copy on PC, and unfortunately, I couldn't, for the life of me, get it installing slash downloading. So installing was fine, but I had all sorts of issues and dramas for at least a month trying to get it to download. Thankfully, on PC, I just pretty much gave up. So I spent a month or so trying to figure out how to bloody get it installed and downloaded. So the big thing was downloading. It seemed to be, like, I left it for 3 to 4 days and I had only downloaded like 2 gigs. So it had seemed to be some kind of throttling problem. But I'm pleased to say on the Xbox Series X, it downloaded very quickly and very easily. And it also gave you an option of, do you want to install the entire package or do you want to install just the online stuff? And that was about 45 gigs, I think. And there was another option to download the offline world for another 50 gigs. And I was like, well, no brainer for me. I just want to play online. And may as well just download just the online bit. So that was save me 50 gigs of download. I don't think we had that option on PC initially. So fingers crossed it's there on PC as an option now. I'm pretty sure it is actually. But on Series X, Flight Simulator. So I've just, all I've done so far to load it in is just boot it up, have a look at a quick look at the options. Downloaded the premium content, so I was given the premium and deluxe edition. I downloaded that stuff, even though it says standard there. I'll just log into it now. It looks like the premium deluxe. I had to download a few extra gigs once I got into the game, get the extra content. That was only about 3.5 gigs, I think. And then I got straight in, so I did the first little flight tutorial. So as I said, I've never played it before on PC, and first time on Xbox, so pretty excited to be getting into it finally. It's that iconic music. So I'm using a Elgato HD 60S. Plus,
press any button to start
to connect the Xbox Series X to my PC to be able to stream, and it's set at 1080p 60, so all the tests, I did a few little test records and things, and it seemed to be recording at 1080p 60, which is amazing, and it looks really bloody cool. Runs nice and smooth. As I said, I only did the first tutorial, didn't even fly anywhere, I just sat in the plane and looked around the plane and learned the controls. So interesting to see how it flies, how it handles the graphics in the flight. But let's get straight into it. Okay. So I only did some really quick controls in the setup. I'm going to just go into, here we go, so it's checking for updates, see if there's anything more to do. Hopefully not, because I was just in the game and playing the tutorial, so we shall see. And hopefully it doesn't take too long. This is the kind of thing that got me stuck on the PC version. And this music drove me out in the wall on the PC, because it's at the time you couldn't turn it off. Really annoying. Yes! Not. Oh man! Another! What's got? Another 1 gig update since I played. Alright. Shouldn't take too long. Fingers crossed. Just let that download. So this is the premium and deluxe upgrades. So pretty lucky to get those. Now landing on Xbox. So true. As I said, haven't played this at all. La La Land 2K, how are you, mate? Hello from Volgograd, Russia. Hello indeed. How are you, good sir? Long time no type. I've started streaming because I'm playing New World on YouTube, but I haven't streamed live. I've been doing a lot of offline recording. I find, because I've got two little girls, 4 and 1, it's hard to live stream and have them come on the camera, etc. So I've been doing a lot of offline recording, but try to do a little bit more live streaming because it's fun. And how are you, La La Land? Light assisting, 22 training flights, holy dooly. All right, we're in. Boom. So it doesn't take too long. It does say up here, downloads have started in the background. So I don't notice it, we'll see. Now, I'm just gonna go into my options. General options. So for graphics, we don't get any graphics options. It's just HDR10 is off, and that's it. There's no tweaking of anything. Camera. So I don't know. I haven't flown yet. Thanks, you're fine. I like flight simulators. I haven't played a flight sim. I haven't played Microsoft Flight Simulator for many, many years. It'd probably go back to the 90s, I would say. It's been ages. I play a lot of space flight sims, but not actual flight simulators. Excuse me. So it's got real-time air traffic, aircraft traffic. Data, what's that? Excuse me. Stream photorealistic 3D buildings in supported areas. Potentially gigabytes of data. Well, we shall see. I wonder if... Yeah, we'll see. My connection is not that good, but... We'll play. So live weather, multiplayer's on. Other players you see in flight are determined by your flight conditions, okay. Flight model, modern, miscellaneous. Units of measure on hybrid. Similar to metric system but uses feet rather than flying. Pilot avatar. Have a look. Nice. Oh, that's me. Well, let's see what else there is. Cool. Love the options. Use the default avatar. Okay. Well, let's go with old mate there. Co-pilot avatar. The same options? Yeah, okay. Let's get this guy here. Instructor. A female instructor. Why not? About a flight simulator. Fine. Accessibility. Enable the screen narrator. Adjust whether the user interface is spoken aloud by a narrator. No, I'm pretty good for now, but we'll see. No white pilots. I'm just using the model that reflects what I look like. Traffic. Done that. Alright, general options done. Apply and save. I don't know anything about assist or control options. How are you, Doyle Rules? Welcome to the stream. What's the marketplace? It's got a question. So you can get the full catalog, deluxe upgrade, already got. Premium deluxe upgrade, already got. Oh, cool, look at that. Top Rudder 103 Solo. What else can you get for free? Board update 3, United Kingdom. Update 4 is France, Belgium, Netherlands, and Luxembourg. Board update 5 is Nordics. Nice. Won't get those yet. I don't know what to do yet. World update. What does that mean? Or is that these things again? Cool. Oh, well, that's the marketplace. I mean, there's probably heaps of stuff. Look in the full catalog. Why not? Ah, you got Japan, USA, the Nordics, Aviators Club livery, which is installed already. Current platform on sale. Probably nothing on sale yet because we're on fresh on the Xbox Series X, so it hasn't released yet. Comes out July 27th, so keep an eye out on that if you've pre-ordered. Actually, it's on Game Pass, so it's going to be day one Game Pass. How could? Xbox Game Pass is legendary. Alright, so I'm going to do a bit more flight training because I haven't flown before at all. Bear with me. I'll do basic handling. I'll do a couple. You guys might be able to help me. You might say it's too easy and just learn by doing, which I often do, but let's have a look. This one, getting familiar with the aircraft main controls and instruments, the yoke to control the ailerons and the elevator, the rudder pedals to control the rudder and steering on the ground, the throttle and RPM indicator, the tachometer, airspeed indicator and altimeter. Okay. Pedals of braking system, hold the brake, press the upper part of your pedals with your valves. That's if you're using real pedals. Nice. Seems pretty damn realistic. I wonder, I haven't watched any YouTube videos or anything like that. I wonder if like real pilots get a kick out of this game. There we are. Ready to fly.
Let's get you familiar with the aircraft, a Cessna 152, and a few commands to navigate it through the skies.
Okay.
In front of you is the yoke. The yoke is like a steering wheel, more or less. Turn it left or right to control the ailerons and bank the aircraft into turns.
Okay.
Look at the trailing edge of the wings while turning the yoke to see the effect on the ailerons.
Oh, I see. Nice.
Okay. Now, the difference between the yoke and a steering wheel is you can pull or push on the yoke. This controls the elevator at the back of the aircraft to make it climb or descend. Look at the horizontal stabilizer while you pull on the yoke. You can see how it affects the elevator.
Oh. Nice.
Nice. Down at your feet are the rudder pedals. They steer the aircraft when you're on the ground. The upper part of the pedals also control your brakes. In the air, they control the rudder at the end of the vertical stabilizer to yaw the aircraft. This is mostly for small corrections. For coordinating turns or compensating for a plane's tendency to pull left during takeoffs and climbs. Look at the vertical tail while operating the pedals to see the effect on the rudder.
Oh yeah?
Great.
Us.
Last but not least, the throttle is located near the center of the cockpit. Pushing forward will increase power, pulling back will decrease power. First, look at the throttle and select it.
Ah.
Keep it selected and push it forward to increase power. Power is increased. Now, pull it back to decrease power.
Yes, playing the Xbox version. I got an early review copy from Xbox and Microsoft. So got to play it a little bit early. And you'll see my review on GameOnAus.com. That's GameOnAus.com on the 27th. But I can't say anything about a rating at the moment. All I can do is play and show you how it runs and what it looks like. Okay, so I've got to pull the throttle.
Power is decreased. Now hey, we'll do the same without focusing on it. Deselect the throttle.
Buckle in, because Inferno is at the controls, and it's going to be a freaking bumpy ride. Okay. Hold A to increase. Increase throttle, is that what I'm doing? Discover the fry controls. Ah.
Set your throttle to idle.
Hold B on this. Hold B to decrease the throttle. So.
Excellent.
Oh. Okay.
When the engine is on, you'll be able to see the power change on your RPM indicator.
So what I'm doing is I'm playing on the Series X, streaming it through my PC so that I can put it on Twitch on a good frame rate. And using the Elgato HD60S+.
This tells you how fast the engine is spinning in hundreds of revolutions per minute. Next, take a look at your current speed on the airspeed indicator. It's on the left in the main instrument panel. It measures the speed in knots.
So many instruments. I need, like, sticky notes.
To check your altitude, look to the altimeter. It's on the right side of the main instrument panel. The altimeter has three hands, similar to a clock. The long, thick pointer indicates 100-foot intervals. The short, thick one is 1,000-foot intervals. And the long, thin one, 10,000-foot intervals. That's all for today. Next time, we'll see how it feels in the air.
Whoa, we're going in the air. Okay, next one. A. Pass mark of an A. Nothing less. All right. Training menu. Next one. We've done that, done that. Familiarization flight. Oh, short taste of flight. Nice. Do this. So we're at the Sedona Oak Creek Airport. In this lesson, you will get familiar with the aerial surroundings of Sedona and perform some simple maneuvers under close supervision from your instructor. Quick view to look around, smart cam to automatically focus on a point of interest, which is the airport, pitch up, pitch down turns. Alright, let's fly. Hey Garbs, I tried to get into bloody New World. And I was in like a... So I saw Gamma and Gruntles log in. And they were instantly in. So the server must have just come up. I finished putting Hannah to sleep and came back. And it was probably about 10 minutes, 11 minutes. And then there's a 25-minute queue. So I persisted through that. And literally, and I was setting up my stream and for New World and all that kind of thing. And then...
I've got to say, you chose a great day to go flying.
Literally, as it went to... One,
this session,
you know, less than one,
Luke,
and then one person
with
left.
Basic controls.
Boom,
sound
blue
good?
Screen of death. I was like,
first
oh no,
first,
I've got the
let's
video
get
card problem.
With your surroundings.
But just reset and it was fine. And then so I tried to get back
out
in, and it was a 35 minute wait, and I was like,
you
oh,
can see
that's it.
We have great visibility over Sedona today.
How good. Look at the graphics. Oh my god. I don't know how good it looks on the stream, but it looks freaking good on the Xbox. Look at that. That's insane. They use the quick view holding that.
This is Red Rock territory.
Oh, you can see it. Beautiful, isn't it? Oh, I'm such a noob.
See if you can spot the Sedona Airport.
You're not the runway should like be a pretty easy landmark to find. Yeah, I'm kind of like, I want to play to get to level 25 to see what a dungeon is, but also I don't because it's gonna,
There you go. Oh. Visual confirmation on the airport.
Oh, there's the airport. Uh-oh. Enjoy the view. Okay, so the next step is outside here. I kind of want to see more, but I don't want to. I want to be like full immersion when we get to release. It's only, 6 weeks away to release now? If not 5 weeks maybe? I can wait. Alright, enjoy the view as the instructor flies.
We already talked about basic controls while we were on the ground. Time to see how it all feels in the air.
There's a lot of cars moving down there.
The aircraft is currently set to a cruise attitude, the position it should be in for regular flight. All right, now let's try banking into a turn by moving the yoke. I'll go first.
Alright. Oh, he's got the spew bag. Oh, this is amazing. This is my first time seeing it.
As a general rule, you always want to keep your turns under 30 degrees.
I've been playing on PC the last
11
months, lucky you. I couldn't get into my PC version. I've been sitting there spewing on the sidelines. Let the instructors demonstrate.
Go ahead and try rolling to the right.
Oh god, I'm in control.
You have controls.
Oh Jesus.
Turn right.
Easy.
Toward the city of Sedona. Excellent. Make sure any control movements are soft and gentle.
I'm trying. Try not to panic.
As we're flying towards Sedona, let's try climbing up and down. Gently pull on the yoke to climb. Give it a try.
Yeah, people, you pull back to go up, just like on a mouse, invert mouse. Hold your pitch for 5 seconds.
That's good. For the descent, it's the same principle, except you're pushing on the yoke. Go ahead, gently pitch down.
Oh god. Pull back too quick, I felt it vibrate. Okay, gently push forward. Hold your pitch for 5 seconds.
That's good. Okay, time to find the airport again. Look around.
Underneath me.
And when you found it, make a turn in that direction.
Do A? No. That's right, I'm here. Oh, so it's underneath me. Sedona says left. Let's go this way. Oh, I see. There's a little... Oh, it's underneath me.
Make sure any control movements are soft and gentle.
Okay.
Now that you're more familiar with the aircraft and the surroundings...
So
the next step is to go deeper into handling and techniques. Soon enough, you'll be able to enjoy trips all on your own.
Awesome. Oh, I got a C. Boo. Does it tell me why? Best score. Man, I thought I was wicked. What did I do? Bank your plane into a turn toward the city. Fail. Gently pull it. Gently. That's fair enough. That's totally fair. I was nervous, all right? I had shaky hands. Oh, look at that. Just short of B. And you can restart and do them again. That's cool. Training me.